still common in the States. So yeah, I'm sure there's a lot of time. So what?
Yeah, thank you.
Yes. Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
And if you could choose what girl of the show you could be, what girl would you?
She gets emotional a lot, but she's tough. But that was a great situation.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Hi, Megan.
Hi.
Hello.
Do you admire someone in your life? Someone special?
My grandfather.
Your grandfather?
Yeah. Yeah, my grandfather. Me.
Why?
Oh. No, he's just, he's just a strong man. I was born at the southern tip of Texas and came over to California. And just hardworking, fourth generation, from mentors. Just work hard, hours and hours in factories, just every job you could. And I just figured, what I have and what I'm, blessed with. Wouldn't have been without, working 7 days a week, all day, out in the fields, and factories and stuff. So, I regret my heart.
Okay, nice answer. Thank you.
I would never push a girl to want to like me or make a decision now or never. I would just be like, I'm just going to go with this and sooner and sooner later you're going to make a decision that I'll do it. And I'll maybe wait for you a little bit. Because we're loving you forever, but that's tough. That's tough. I'd be more certain than that. Oh, thank you. Good.
Hi, Michael.
Hi.
My question is, which is the most city that you actually believe the most?
It's probably every different ones, every transformation. It's just so tedious, there's so many different angles you have to get, and it's like, and then you have to put in, special effects coming on the shoot. We'll shoot like scene after scene after scene, and then it'll be like, okay, now we need to put in the veins, and then we put in these dots, so like hair makeup, and they put dots all over the face. Little like marker, they put dots like here, two, yeah, by the end of it, you have dots all over the face, on your arms and stuff. Dots all over, so later on the post production, you make it, special effects, but all in all, mannerisms and transformation. So every transformation scene is the hardest for me, anyway, filming. All the other scenes, it's mainly just dialogue and stuff, and little stunts here and there.
Okay, thank you. I love you.
I love you too.
Hi, Michael.
Hi.
I got a question about performing in general. What's going on through your mind when you have to do a scene when you have to cry during this? It's like
it depends on like if it's like an emotional cry because you know you're angry or you're heartbroken or you're just sad. Yeah, there's a big library in my head of things that you just kind of pick from. Or you know, sometimes it's a song. Sometimes you just, you know, I have like my iPod with it kind of nearby and I'll be listening to, you know, kind of just get emotional, just get in a certain state. And then once they start saying, you know, rolling, you know, action, I'll take out real quick and throw it and go and do the scene. So that helps, but it's just a lot of mental preparation the night before of you know, what you're going to use to get you there. Because it's like everything else, you know, your whole body is an instrument, it's a tool. And with acting, it's not about just saying lines and looking pretty or something. It's, you know, it's so much more than that. And so you have to practice your tool, just like, you know, you have to practice guitar or anything else, you practice singing. Your vocals, and you just have to keep your whole body so that they leave the night before and just think about what's going to get me there quickly. But I don't get there so much, like, that deep because you'll just end up using it and then wasting it. Because if I try to think of the same thing the next day, then it's not going to work. And then I'm just there, like, you know, stuck. So you have to grab a bunch, you know, certain things in your life, whatever, you know, be a picture. It could be something simple, you know, as a photo that you look at that gets you emotional, or a song, like I said. And you just gotta find different parts for you. Everybody's different.
Thank you. I love you too.
Hello.
Hello.
My question is, which three things you would take to a desert Iceland?
What's that? Well, let's see. I would say photos. You know, if I could get off that island, I'm stuck. Whatever. I would take photos. Every photo that I own, family photos and everything. You need music. Myself, I would take photos, I would take music, like, be it song in your iPod or iTunes, take all that. And then, I would take somebody special with me.
What?
You mean who? I'm not telling you. Yeah, I would take somebody special with me.
Thank you, I love you.
I love you too.
Hi.
Hi.
First of all, sorry because I don't speak pretty well. My question is, when did you decide to, you wanted to act?
It's funny because I wasn't a child actor, I don't know anything in the business. I graduated high school, and then after high school I did 1 year at a junior college. And I was going to do 2 years at the junior college and then go to the University of Southern California, which had always been a dream of mine. I just always really wanted college and graduate with a degree. But in my first year at junior college, I was still very immature. I was still in high school pretty much. I was falling asleep in class. I was being late to class. I wasn't paying attention. I was just taking a right time. I was still in high school, and I knew I was wasting my time. And so, you know, I was smart enough to know that. And so I just always felt that I had I always thought I could be a performer, you know, be an actor. And so I just decided one day, screw it, I'm gonna go after it and see if I can pull it